Welcome back to Metroid Dread Dread Mode, where we are in the final stretch. 10% items. I always thought I made it to 11%. I guess not. Either way, last stretch. Final video. Either we win this or we give up and lose at Ravenbeak. As I said at the end of the last video, I do not doubt for even a second that I can get by the Chozo Warriors. I hope I can do it in one try on each because they are hard to rapidly mash against on this arm. Very hard. So, all the best wishes, all the best luck on that. I would really, truly appreciate it. We're off to a great start. Not the first time that's happened either. Normally it doesn't kill me though. Like, I've run into that enemy more times than little. Just being stupid. I usually dash step into him, the thing. But not this time. Or flash step, not dash step. Derp. But, yeah, not this time. I intentionally didn't use flash step so I could get up through there. And I just continued walking left because I wasn't really paying a whole heck of a lot of attention. I would be curious, and I might eventually do a second run where it'll just be for me to see how much better I do without talking at all. But I... Final part, we'll go all the way to the end. If I can beat it, make your predictions now. What do you think is there for death? You haven't seen them all, I can guarantee you that. There's been a handful you haven't seen at this point. But you've seen a good chunk of them. You know what, if I wouldn't have been hitting over, okay. So I mentioned this spot in the last video. I didn't say what I was worried about, but that was what I was worried about. Coming back in through this way is going to be really hard without taking a hit. But I think if I can do it, if it'll let me do a Shine Spark while we're in here, it will. So we're good. I wasn't sure if it would or not, because the Shine Spark when you're in the ball always makes you raise. So I was kind of worried that we might die there. By the way, we'll skip this scene. We'll go through here carefully because I've been hit here before. I was going to say I've died here before. I've never died here. Hopefully this doesn't kill us. I mean, it is technically something that hits us. Back. Jump. You know what's annoying? You get this shot that actively goes through everything, and then you immediately fight an enemy that has a shield that you can't shoot through. Okay, we're good here. Unless I screw this up. Which is possible. I've screwed it up before. We're good here. But yeah, you get this wave shot. It's supposed to shoot through anything. Shoot through walls. Shoot through walls. What more can you want, right? But then you get these stupid red and gold Chozos with this shield that looks like their armor. And you can't shoot through that. But you can shoot them and their armor, and they die. Should they not be impenetrable or impregnable, they shouldn't be able to be hit by it, is what I'm saying. It's a continuity error that really annoys me, if I'm to be honest. Like, really annoys me. It's always been something just, it's stupid. You get this ultimate gun, and then it immediately becomes useless. You don't even get used out of like a second. Not even a second. Please just charge up. Great, I didn't let off the button in time. But I'm trying to get some good. We at least got one. I would prefer to get two. If we would have got two, I could have used another one in that room back there to get through here a little quicker. I mean, it's fine. This isn't costing us, it's not like we have to worry about time, is what I should say. So I shouldn't let it bother me in that regard. So normally I wouldn't stop here, and, oh, he doesn't even talk anymore. He's like, nah, I'm done. You've skipped me, actually I haven't skipped, no, I still technically skipped him some. Alright, so we'll do this, play that, play this, and we go up through just as it breaks, which is satisfying to say the least, at least I think it is. There's an enemy on this side of the door. I just want to run through him The camera didn't follow me. I thought I died. So, Golden Chozo. Wish me luck. This guy's the one that really hurts my arm. And he's gonna do the stupid flippy jumps off the bat instead of doing the... Oh, you are the worst. That means he's gonna get his shield up. Yeah, he's gonna get his shield up. Come on. Nope. I don't know why it didn't grab onto it. I really don't. I'm really confused. But if he does the jumps up on the wall right off the bat instead of charging at you, I can't shoot fast enough to kill him in time before he gets his shield up. Which is a little annoying. And it usually results in me getting hit. And he's doing it again because of course he is! Oh god! I know why it didn't work the first time. I went for the grapple right off the bat. So I'm probably gonna have to take this fight slower because this is really starting to hurt my arm. I hate this fight if you have to do it more than once. It does my arm in. Having tendonitis makes the last leg of this game terrible. It causes so much pain. Why couldn't you do this the first time, you piece of crap? What? So I had to switch to my right hand there because my left hand, you could see the big gaps in my button mashing. And when I went and switched back over, I think I must hit left bumper. Oh my god, I hate this fight. I normally take one hit in it. I can't take that hit. Oh god, my arm hurts so much right now. And I've only done this 3 times. Oh my god. It's fine. Shake it out. Screw you. My. What happened? Okay. That one annoys me because he never touched me as far as I could tell. Okay, we're definitely going to take this fight super slow then because I can't deal with the rapid firing anymore. I'm no good at the fight using this, but this is how we're doing it. I didn't get my grapple, or I didn't get my melee in time. Ghost, I hate this fight. This fight can either go really well or really bad for me, and today is one of those days. Like, there's times, even in a regular speedrun, I'll die to this fight, like, 10 plus times, because it's just one of those days. It will not cooperate with me. And today is definitely one of those days. Oh, I missed him with that. Couldn't afford that. I really appreciate when she doesn't use the grapple. Please. Why? Okay, we'll just take this fight as slow as possible. Okay, we're out of missiles, so back to rapid firing. Because my rapid firing is down the drain right now. There we go. Oh my god, my arm hurts so bad right now. You don't know the half of it. I wish I could absorb it and be back to full health. My god, I wish that. Oh my god, it hurts so much. Take care of yourselves, I guess is the takeaway from this. When I was younger, and what gave me tendonitis like this is when I was younger, I had an old computer that a neighbor gave me. It was my first computer. It was a computer that had Windows 98 on it. I got it in like 2004, 2005. I didn't have a proper setup for using that. So whenever I'd use it, like with the mouse and stuff, say this right here was the surface I had my mouse on. My wrist would always be pressed up against the sharp edge like this as I was using the mouse, and it just kept grinding across here. That is what started my tendonitis. And then a game called Luminari Rise of the Gunzu did not help matters any. Really did not help matters any. We'll stop right here and do this. So that made things much worse. Now, wish me luck, we're going to need every last ounce of it. I'm actually going to take half a second. I'm going to cancel this. I'm going to take half a second, let my arm rest, and then we'll try to beat Ravenbeak. If we're lucky, we'll make this a very, very short video. I don't expect it to be a very, very short video. Let's just put it that way. All right, the rest is doing nothing but make my arm wet because I put my water bottle, which does not have much ice in it anymore, up against it, hoping it would help. And all it did was make my athletic sleeve wet, which definitely not an athlete, but it does help with the tendonitis a lot because it compresses through here. All right, let's see if we can one and done this. We're totally not one and dunning this. I'm really curious to see how the end of it goes, because I'm curious if we'll be invulnerable to stuff. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So now we need a little RNG help here. Oh, he's not gonna cooperate. Cooperate. Jump over me, thank you. No. You know what? That's fine. Just do a 10 one of these, and we're good. Oh no, we're dead! Oh my god! That looks so much more devastating. She hits the wall so hard that her armor explodes. Oh, that death I'm not sad about at all, because that was truly epic. Just the way that it happened. Just the long fly back. Just slow motion. Perfect. I love that. Actually love that. It looks like the punch to the stomach was just so devastating. 8, 9. Alright, we'll take this out. 3, 4. Normally I would just jump into that because I could take the hit. Really? 1, 2. I gotta go up over it. Oh my god, you're being the worst right now. Can you just... Thank you. Oh my god, seriously? I can't rapid fire enough right now. I just can't. There we go. Phase 1 and 2 done. We're on to phase 3. Phase 3, if I take this careful... Oh, Jesus, really? Take it careful, and I dash straight into him. So normally, what I would do with that attack is just melee off to the side and start shooting. But, I tried it with hard mode. There is a way to get by it. There was a couple times I did it without taking a hit, but I'm not 100% sure what I did. So, the alternative is I just have to keep circling around him, take it careful. And that was not careful enough, because I literally dashed straight into him because I didn't go high enough. I can say this though, compared to the start of the series, I thought I had no chance. But the fact that we're here at the end, I think I can do this now. And then he immediately just freaking body checks me. And kills. I've never seen him start off with that attack. Like seriously, he's never, ever, out of the 100 plus runs I've done, I've never seen him start off with his sharp claws at you. His three strike attack. He does literally everything else but that. I've never seen that before. Oh, this is a bunch of firsts. Like, this is what you usually see. And then, yeah, this. think that's 9. I wasn't counting. We're gonna hope it was 9. Doesn't matter. I couldn't get the jump up in time. See what I mean? He normally starts with stuff like this. 7, 8, and 9. Now we just wait them out. You know, if you're really lucky, I wish I could do it the other way, but I can't actively you jerk. I can't actively attack fast enough. You need to be able to press at about 15 hertz. There we go. And what that means is you need to be able to attack about 15 times, or press the button about 15 times per second. Oh, really? And I don't have the room to get out around you easily. Thank you for giving me more room, at least. He's gonna go down, so I'll do this. Gonna dash down, dash up. Go into that, huh? Did not mean to lay that. I meant to jump first. Dash. Behind him. Okay. Again, really? You know this is the best chance to get me, don't you, jerk? Go down. Oh my god, are you kidding me right now? And I jumped up into him. Oh my god. I've never seen him do that so much. 2 to 3 times is usually... Well, usually I'd have him beat by that time too, but I can't attack him through that attack, so... Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. We're going to see you in phase 3. I'm done showing you phase 1. Let's do that. Phase 3 actually comes really fast. If... Oh my god, you're going for a double? Oh my god, I'm missing everything. Why? Oh, I took a risk there. I hate you right now, Ravenbeak. You know I can't do anything. Alright, that's fine. That's fine. I'm not getting annoyed. Okay. Focus time. Focus time or something. Jesus. I knew that phase there was going to be my troublemaker. I knew it was going to give me trouble. And sure enough, it is giving me all of the trouble. Alright, we're going to risk something here. If he goes for... No, I can't. I was going to say, if he goes for that shot and he went for it twice, I was going to try to react quick enough to it and just straight up shoot him or fix him. Like, I was going to try to react fast enough and get the melee attack in early so I could just get out of there and do what we need to do. But I can't react quick enough and he gets following on me too directly and I don't think I can do anything because of it. I'd rather not chance it. I missed him with that one. Yeah, keep doing more of this. This is great. Drop down on me. I dare ya. Yeah, I can take twice. Wanna go for a third? Anything but this. This is actually the worst thing he can keep doing. He should be just about done phase 3, though. Okay. Oh my god, again? Like I said, I've never seen him do... Oh god! Oh, I'm out of missiles. Okay. Oh my god, he was that close. Now, if I do phase 4 careful, we might get it here. And this shows just how badass he is. Since we're not doing the speedrun, I'm watching it. Oh, he literally ripped that out of the bone. Hey, you're gonna come all the way over? I'm A-okay with that. I'm taking this fight, as I said, super duper careful.
I will take all the advantages I can get, old man.
Oh, that's like the one attack that could do me in here. And I'm taking this super careful. Oh, we've won. We beat it. Unless I screw this up. Oh. Did not. Can't speak yet. We haven't technically beaten him. And, you know, I don't know what happens if you die here. I've died here too. I just don't remember what happens. But that aside, what we're looking to do here, we're waiting for him to snap his little paw down twice. So, here's number one, and there's number two. And just before we take our shot, he'll say, "Say my name." And then you shoot him in the face and say, "Mother effer, your name is dead." And then he dies. Say your name. Your name is dead. Dead. Now, my only worry here is, like, normally you're invincible in this form. You can walk through anything. I'm going to test that out. Because they, God damn it. For whatever reason, they might have it set up so we take damage if we hit enemies. And I want to test that. We'll see right here. No, we're invincible. We've beaten the game then. I don't need to rush through this by any means. I will try to get through a little faster than I am currently going, though. Like, seriously. I was up way too high on that jump. That's fine. I didn't mean to jump up and hit him. That just makes me seem mean at this point. Well, not how I wanted to take it. You know what? It's fine. We'll do it. We'll deal with it. I'm curious about something. We can do that there. Is there a point to it? No, that didn't really save us any time at all. There is a spot right here, and I can't do it, but there's a spot there that you can save time if you can do it. So you get into that, you try and spark directly down to the ground, and then you can continue with your speed. I meant to save that. You know what, we're fine. Take down, gotta go up through the slowest halfway. You know, it's fine in the end. We still have plenty of time. Screwing all the jumps up. I let go of left too early. Either way, with it. Over there reaching again. We done it. We beat it on dread mode. And within one sitting, I mean, it was like a 5-hour setting, I'll admit. I started recording this at quarter eight, I think it was. And it's 12:50 right now. So 4-hour setting and some change. Let's see what our in-game time in the other time they show is. Whew, but yeah. Starting this off, did not expect to be able to beat this at all. The fact that not only did I beat it, I gotta move. No, let's just move this over here. So clear time, and that's the in-game time, 2:24:04. God, where do I have to go for this? There, that'll work, sort of. God, I still feel like I gotta move over that way more. But everything's mirrored, and I gotta move weird with it, or not mirrored, I mean. So, mission result, dread mode, 2:24, total playtime, 4 hours, 22 minutes, that's pretty accurate, actually. And, times defeated, 107, what'd you have, over or under? I thought for sure it would be over 200, so the fact that we got in under half that, or around half that, I'm not going to complain. I saved 23 times, technically, since I sat here on all one setting, I could have done it without saving at all. But I wanted to save just to have those checkpoint rooms in areas I wouldn't normally have them. Either friggin' way, we managed to beat Metroid Dread. Wow. Let's see if it gives us any any new screens here. They don't. Are you kidding me? Nothing? Is there at least nothing in the extras either? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me right now? Nothing. I don't know how to get anything from the Chozo things either. I'm guessing you gotta beat the game at 100% on all difficulties or something. But Dread Mode gives you nothing. Not even in the gallery? No, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Because I had this from before, and I really like that image. That would make an awesome desktop background. Absolutely wonderful desktop background. I really like that image. But it's all Metroid. Like, Metroid throughout the ages. You have the Emmys with Dread. You have the Chozo. That looks like the Quiet Beak. I'm guessing the commander over there is the original Adam from Metroid Other Mission or Other M. You have an actual Metroid in the background. Oh, it's probably the one that she rescued, the little tiny one, the baby. You have Kraid in the background. You have... I don't know what his name is. I don't know at all what his name is. The green four-eyed thing. I think it's probably from... I want to say Super Metroid, but I'm not sure, honestly. You have the space pirates. You have the more evil Metroids. They have them made a little more menacing looking. Mother Brain up there, I think. You got Ridley. Yeah, that'd be Mother Brain's second form from Super Metroid. And, of course, dear old dad in the upper left corner. Dear old dad. You get Kraid after he gets taken over by an axe. Either way, I think this is a pretty good spot to end this series. Well, I mean, it's the end of the series, so of course it is. If you did happen to enjoy this series, leave it a big old thumbs up. Really appreciate it. If you think someone else would enjoy it, don't hesitate to share. I'm always welcoming to new people. I mean, I respond to every comment I possibly can. My throat's actually really killing me right now. I should probably shut up and get ready for bed. It's like 1 a.m. Yeah. I think that's what I'll do. So, look forward to whatever's going up alongside this, which Terraria is for sure. Probably some Mario Maker, maybe. Yeah, probably at least two parts of Mario Maker. And I don't know. I've mentioned this before. Since Mega Man Maker's been gone, really been struggling to find a proper foothold to keep content out. I really struggle with it. So I know that's not a good thing, but what can you do? Either way, these videos are off to the side now. Check them out. Subscribe that button down below if you're new here. And leave the video a like, too. I'm not going to complain. See you guys in whatever I put up next. Later.